What's up everyone, this is Blake Moose, aka the Black Moose, and here I have the CDJ-3000s and the DJM V10, and I'm going to show you guys the various ways on how to connect your decks over to Rekordbox. Let's check it out. Okay, let's look at using export mode. So simply you're using your computer as a glorified USB drive to your set. Let's first of all look at the connections. Connect your audio cable, whether it's line in or through the digital out, and connect them to the line in or the digital in of the mixer. In this example, I'm using channels 3 and 4 on the DJM V10. Now connect the LAN cables to your switch hub or wireless router and the other ends to your CDJs and mixer, if the mixer has that option. Make sure you have a USB to Ethernet adapter for your computer if it doesn't have a LAN port. Or if you're using a router, connect to the router over Wi-Fi. Now get onto export mode in Rekordbox. Once you're connected, the link button will automatically pop up after a few seconds at the bottom left of the screen. Click link and you'll be able to see that your decks are linked. You can now browse through your library on your CDJs. If you cannot find the link button, make sure that you've turned off firewall and any antivirus software, as that might be blocking it. As you can see, it's playing, but there's no sound coming out. I have the faders up, I've got the trim up, but make sure you've selected the right source. I'll select this to line, and here we go. What I'll also mention, make sure you've got your play-in numbers set correctly. You'll need to disconnect the LAN cable in order to select the right player. And that's pretty much it for export mode. Now let's look at performance mode. Here we'll be using our decks to control the software. Let's look at the first method, which is CDJ aggregate. First of all, connect your audio cables to your mixer and also connect the USB cables from each of your CDJs to your computer. Now this next bit applies to Mac users. Google up the CDJ model and add driver at the end. Get to the driver page and what you'll notice is a CDJ aggregator tool. Download that and install. What this does, it will combine both CDJs to an aggregate driver. PCs do this automatically. And here's the proof of it. Pioneer CDJ XDJ aggregate device. So let's head over to Rekordbox. Make sure you're on performance mode. Head over to preferences, go to audio, and then select your aggregate device. And boom, as you can see that it has been discovered, and now you're able to select the deck of each player. As you scroll on your CDJs, it would replicate that on each screen and also the Rekordbox screen. Also check that you select the right source again on your mixer. I've selected line here. If you still have your channels mixed up, check in the audio preferences that your CDJs are sending the sound to the right channel. The second method is to include the mixer. Connect another USB cable to it. With Rekordbox open, you'll be prompted to install an audio driver if you haven't done so. By the way, I've made a video on how to do this on a Mac, so check that out. What you need to do here is change the source to the USB or the PC icon on your mixer, because now Rekordbox is sending the audio directly to the mixer and you're using the CDJs to control it. And the third method is with Pro DJ Link. So what I'm doing now is disconnecting the USB cables from the CDJs and check that the LAN cables are connected to the switching hub. Simply everything is running on Pro DJ Link, but the CDJs are still being recognized as a controller, which is pretty cool. And these are the various connection methods in performance mode.
There you have it, guys. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. If you like this video, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe.